So here we are, continuing with Project 1. We've been going through the various steps to get ourselves to completion. You have a MyWeb account set up. You've sent me your information, so I'm going to add you to the website. You've downloaded the template. We were last looking at how to configure Dreamweaver and connect to MyWeb and how to upload files. So at this point, we want to make some changes to your files in Dreamweaver and look at uploading files just a little bit more. So sitting out here on the desktop, we have the same thing that we've been working with. There is the zip or compressed file, and then here we have the uncompressed folder for the local My website. If we open that up, we see the index file that we opened up the other day. We changed our name in it, and we see the different folders for the various classes you might be taking. If we jump back over to Dreamweaver, we've set this up for MyWeb, so you see that I have MyWeb selected for the site. Since we've already set it up for MyWeb here, you'll notice that the files here match the same files that we have sitting on our desktop. So those are the exact same files again. The other day we opened the index file, we changed one thing, I believe we just changed our name, and we looked at the fact that these were folders for other classes that you might be taking. What we want to do right now is we want to look at editing files just a little bit more. So I'm going to double click the index file. Again, this is the main file. We would call it the default file or the home page because it is the index file sitting at the root level. This is where we changed our name the other day. We've got multiple files showing here, and if we scroll down, you'll see the portions of your resume down here. Go ahead and feel free to start filling in some information here because this is going to be a portfolio site. You can spend some time putting your qualifications in here, related skills, your employment history, so forth. So at this point, this works very much like a word processor. You just highlight the area that you want to work on, and you can type right there. Probably better words than that. Hit undo there and let it go back. So you can highlight and make changes that way. So go ahead and start updating your resume there. I'll slide back up and show you that we do have a link right here when you view the page in the browser that you can Google online design portfolio. Start getting some ideas of what type of information you would have there. Scrolling back up here, we see the various classes again. This is CDES222 that we're working on right now. So if this is the only class that you're taking amongst these right now, you can simply highlight these other classes that you aren't taking and hit the delete key and those will go away. Of course, like any other program here, if you find you've done something and you want it back, do a command Z and it will undo the last thing that you did. I'm going to go ahead and delete them out of mine because we're concentrating on 222, so I'm going to highlight and delete. Scroll back up. Show you just a little bit more about this file right here. So this is basic web design and we're in 222. Notice we're broken out into five different projects here, so those are the five projects for our class. Each of them having a space for a class demo, so this links to a folder for the class demo. So this would be a place that you can work on a file during a tutorial, something that we're going over in class. And then we have the actual completed project right here. So that links to the folder where your completed project is. Let's save this file. Oh, one last thing before I save this file. I wanted to point out the title at the top right here. So you see by default right now it says Your Name Portfolio. This is the title that shows up at the top of a browser window on most browsers right now. Not all browsers do this. Chrome is not doing it, but if you go to Safari, say, it'll have that there. It's important for various reasons. One, you know, it looks pretty unprofessional if it says untitled there when someone goes to your web page. It's also used when you bookmark a page. So somebody goes to your page and bookmarks it, that's the words that it uses for your bookmark. So we want to make it relevant. It's also used in search engines, so there's a lot of value given to that. So I'm going to go and change mine just to read Michael Hayes Portfolio. Nice and simple. So you might want to make that change there. Now I'm going to go up to File and say save. So I've saved the changes, just the few changes I've made there. I'm going to go close my file. We're back out here to the files panel now. So that was the index file we were looking at right there. I wanted to show you just a little bit about the folder structure we have here. Again, remember that this is the same folder structure we have out here. That's the same file I was just modifying. But this is just Dreamweaver looking at it. Looking into 222, I can expand this. You see there's Project 1, there's Project 1 Demo, so on down through Project 5. So each of these are where you're going to store the files that you work on for your projects. So right now we're working on Project 1. A lot of this is set up for Project 1, getting things up and running. There is another piece to this project though. I'm going to go ahead and open this one and see that we have an index file here. Open that one. The other part of the assignment for Project 1 is that you are supposed to do a little bit of research and then in your own words write 250 word short response to the question, what is web design? So this is the file that you would do that in. So you could create a new file and save over this file. That would work. Or you could come in here and highlight the text in this one and type your content right there. Go ahead and answer the question right there. You will need to style it a little bit, but we'll get to that in another video. So I'm going to close this file back out. Just wanted to show you where that sits in here in Project 1 in the CDES222 folder. One last thing we want to look at here on this video is talking again about uploading. So the other day we looked at the fact that we could click on a file. We could click on the put icon here and it would upload it to our server. This of course being, these are the local files right here on the right hand side, the files that are on our desktop. The left hand side here being the files that are on the web server, in this case my web. We can't see anything here right now because we're not connected to the server. See the little plug icon right here, that's our connect button. It shows unplugged, we're not connected, so if I click on that it becomes plugged in. Yeah, it's not showing it very well, but it does. And now I can see the files here on my remote server. So my structure looks the same on both sides. So I showed you the other day that we can click and upload just that one. I could do a shift click and grab all of those and put those. By the way, that's common on the Mac. I can click one item. If I hold the shift key, if I click another one, it grabs everything in between. If I, another similar thing is if I click on one item and I hold down the command key, I can go select another item and it independently is selected. Notice it did not select the item in between. So maybe I want to go down and click the index file while I'm still holding the command key, and I now have those three individual items selected. So that's the simple way to put files up onto the web server. One other thing that I want to show you here before we wrap up is that we are able to synchronize files that are here. So what we can do is I can select just items. In this case, probably the easiest way if I'm going to synchronize is let's go click on the entire site right there. That's our root folder. If I right click, I can come down here to where it says synchronize. I'm going to select that and I get a dialog box. It says synchronize the selected local files only. Well, what I selected is the whole root folder, so that's going to be the entire site. Or the other option is the entire site. So what I've selected is the entire site, so I'm going to stick with that. I have options about whether I'm going to put files, whether the action I'm taking is putting files up, or if I'm getting files from the remote. In this case, I'm putting files up there. So I have made changes on my local site and I want to put only the changed files up there. I'm going to hit preview. It runs through the site. It's comparing the files between local and up on my web server. This could take some time if you're working on a larger site, but it's going to come back and give me a list of any files that have been changed. Now, knowing that we just changed this index file here a moment ago, that should be the only thing that it comes back and lists. So yes, here's my synchronize window. It lists the index files being the only thing that's different. It's suggesting we put it. If you ended up with a whole list of them and you did not want to put all of them, you could select one. And you see right here you have this one that says ignore selected files. So I could click on that one and it would ignore anything that I had selected when I clicked on it. In this case, I do want to put that index file up, so I'm going to say OK, and it's now pushing that file up. It's probably done already. It was a very small file. So we now have that new file sitting up there on the server. In fact, let's run over here to Firefox real quick. And I happen to have my page already loaded here. So again, myweb.csuchico.edu/tilde, your username. So this was already loaded. This was what my page looked like before. The only thing changed was my name. In fact, you notice that right here, here's the title where it says Your Name Portfolio. Okay. And I'm going to refresh this page. You could either click on the refresh, or I could click after the URL and push enter. That'll refresh it. And you see that I have changes made to my page now. So mine now says Michael Hayes Portfolio up here at the top, or you can see it on the tab. And I also deleted the other classes off of here because we're not using those. You can also see that these are all live links. I can go to Project 1 and go to the completed project. That's that page we looked at briefly. We didn't make any changes to it yet, but that's that page. I'm going to click back and look at this. There's my index file. One other thing here in Dreamweaver, just to finish up some thoughts on synchronization. The other option that they give you in synchronization, we can go both directions, or I can get newer files from remote. The best example I know of for getting newer files is if you've worked on a website, whether you designed it from scratch and then uploaded it, or if you're working for a client that you made changes for them on their site and you pushed them up there, but you're not the only person working on the site. So maybe they're working on it internally, maybe they have someone else doing changes sometimes, but you have these, they've come to you now, they want some changes made. You have these files sitting local on your hard drive, but you don't know if they're current because you know that other people work on this site. This over here, this is the live site. This is what people view. And so you want to make sure you're working on the most current files because there's other people involved. So then we can do a synchronize. We can say get newer files from remote and say preview. And it's going to go scan the whole site and see if there's anything up on the web server that is newer than what I have on my hard drive. Now, in this case, there shouldn't be anything there. We really only have the one homepage that we've... Oh, it shows me some things that have changed. This is deceptive. So we're going to not do that. But in this case, you would, in the case that I was explaining, you would go ahead and pull any files that have been changed, then make your edits to it. If you skipped that step and you just made edits to the files you had and then uploaded them to the site, then you would likely be overwriting changes that they had made, which is definitely not a good thing to do to your client. So, okay, that is everything for this video. We're going to pick up again in a couple of minutes, and we're going to look at some of the ways that we can make it easier to keep picking up your site and working on it each time that you come back to the computer.